trasferire un po'
durante la prima
Thank you very much, Karel, for this odyssey.
No way, wow!
You please welcome to Milan for the first time, Tommy Tiernan!
Hello! Hey, there? All well, some Irish in? Where are the Irish? Hello? Hello there. Where's an RD from? Hello there? From Donegal for a basic. Anywhere else? From, you're from Clare, Galway?
No,
oh, Clare. Oh, Clare, I'm Galway. It's very nice when you're in Milan. Any English people in?
Yeah.
That's weird. Hello, hello the English. We forgive you. Just in case you cared. Any Italians in?
Yeah.
Couple down the back. They don't understand. They're here looking scornfully. I was on that road today, the fashion road. What's it called?
Napoleone.
I was there today. I mean, I think it's important when you're a tourist to do the fucking tourist stuff, isn't it? There's no point trying to be clever. So I did the touristy stuff here today. I went to see some big, I can't remember the name, some big fucking church in here. What was it called? The what?
Duomo.
Yeah, that one. It was someplace I went to do it. A very curious thing happened in there. There was a travelling band of American religious singers. And it just struck me the difference between the European and the American sensibility. These people have probably rehearsed for fucking years, dying to come over to Milan and sing it, and maybe they're travelling all over Italy. But the Italian attitude towards things is nothing is that fucking impressive, really, is it? Whatever you do, yeah, I could have fucking done that if I wanted to, but I'm too busy here looking at my shoes. So we went into this church, and it's an amazing church, and it's quite dark, isn't it? I mean, the figures in it, it's not fucking happy religion. It's all the grotesque, and the faces are ugly, and the priest is there with an espresso and a cigarette. It's all fairly, you know, cultured and Italian, and they don't give anything away, you know? If Christ was Italian, he wouldn't have been as effusive. You know, he wouldn't be going around telling people, I love you, I love you. Yeah, you know what, yeah. Do you like my shoes? Your sandals, yeah. Open toed, that's the name of the game. Here we go. So anyway, these American people were in this church, and the church, like all churches all over the world, is full of tortured creatures. Like, if the statues inside the church could make the noises that their faces were suggesting, you wouldn't go near the place, would you? It'd sound like a fucking abattoir. Christ up on the cross. So anyway, this place is a silent, screaming palace. And the Americans there, and the Americans have this, they have a kind of positivity that doesn't sit well anywhere else in the world apart from fucking America. So all the Americans were there. And they're all, I'm happy I found Jesus. I'm happy I found Jesus. This is probably the highlight of their fucking years. Going to Europe to sing and all these, I'm happy I found Jesus. And they're in their minds when they were thinking about it, when they were projecting the experience before they had it, they probably had visions of thousands of Italians gathered around them going, nobody in their church gave a fuck. People were just looking at them like, look at your shoes. You got shit shoes. Ciao bello.
Juve.
Milan.
Liverpool.
People just join in whenever you recognize a word. That's cool. Let's all learn a language together. Anybody for Esperanto? Here we go. Welcome to the show. Where are you from?
Liverpool.
You're from Liverpool? Now, I'm a season ticket holder at Anfield. And I'm not even fucking from there. How many games did you see last year? Call yourself a fan. Walking in here, sitting with the front from Liverpool. Anyway, you're welcome. You're more than welcome.
Grazie.
Molte bene, grazie mille, bello. Anyway, so I went into this, all these fashion shops, right? And it's quite an impressive street, isn't it? It's very, And how come all the fuckers in every single shop dress in black? So I think it's actually, and I don't like the attitude they have when you walk into the shop. They fucking look you up and down, like, what the fuck are you wearing? You piece of shit. You're coming into this shop dressed like that? Fucking idiot. You should be dressed like me. In black. I wouldn't dress like you. What the fuck are you doing here? Look at me. I work in a fucking clothes shop. That's how fucking cool I am. And things are very expensive, aren't they?
Yeah.
Very expensive.
H&M.
Where is that on? That's not on that road though, is it? You wouldn't even be allowed down that road with a H&M bag. The police would stop you. Where the fuck are you going with that bag? Is that where you got your shoes? Take them off, barefoot, off it, fucking go. It's very nice to be here though. What are you all doing in Milan? What do you work at? What's your job?
Don't
tell him. What do you work? What's your job? You're an actor in Milan. Really? An actor in Milan. Actor slash teacher.
Don't
do the slash teacher. Okay, do you want to have a little meeting here at the front table? Break up into groups of four. What have Irish people given to the world? Think about that. You walk around Milan, all the fantastic fucking buildings and fashion, and these people, they've made their mark on the planet. What the fuck? We're like the knackers of Europe, so we are. Not much better than the Romanians. We're just... We're clean tinkers. That's all the fuck we are. We've done nothing to deserve to be here. Words, people say. Irish people are great with words. They're not even our fucking words. Somebody else is our duty. The English came over and they gave us their language. Our duty is to fuck it up and hand it back to them all reinterpreted. That's all we can do. That's what Joyce did. He fucked up the sentence. And that's what Becca did. He pared it down to no meaning. That's all we can do. And that's why we curse. Fuck you! Fuck this! Fuck that! Fuck off! Who the fuck? When the fuck? Cunt is a term of endearment in Ireland! How are you? Who's cunt you? Fish. Fish are fucking stupid. Fish have no memory. 3 seconds of fucking memory. They're the daftest, most unintelligent, forgetful fucking creatures in the world. Yet, eating them imp-
improves your fucking memory. Fish oil is good for your head. I don't fish. Even fish who fucking eat fish still stay fucking stupid.
Thank you. The Italians are fairly religious, aren't they? Will there be mass tomorrow morning? Will it be worth it? Have you gone to Italian mass?
No.
No,
I have actually. Yeah.
And is it good?
It's in Italian.
And you were surprised? Excuse me, Padre! Padre! No comprende a fucking word, though. What's going on? No, I don't get it. I don't get it. What language did you expect it to be in? Fucking Hebrew? Are Jewish people in?
Yeah.
You're Jewish as well. You're the Benetton of offence. So anything, you're just going to say, yeah, it's me. Yeah. Are you Jewish, really?
I
do. You feel like my trainers? Okay, could you answer the question? Are you Jewish? You're not Jewish, okay. Just want to join in up at the front. That's what you're saying. What's your name? What's your name? Were you, you're like a sniper. You only shoot when no one's looking at you. That's cool. Okay, what's your name?
Liam.
Liam, and your parents were at the mass and...
They came to visit me here in Milan.
All right. Okay, how are you, Liam? Oh, fuck, let's go to mass. Oh, wow, okay. And did they enjoy it?
They're really religious, so they always enjoy it.
Oh, right, okay. And you just went along to keep them company?
Exactly.
But you didn't understand a fucking word of it?
Neither did they.
Neither did they? God. Okay. I can't think of anything funny to say. So we'll just move on. The last Olympic Games in Greece. No, non-Irish people know about this. Do you know about this, Andy? You probably do. I mean, if you don't, it's not going to stop you talking about it. We won the gold medal. One fucking gold medal. For show jumping. One medal and we had to use an animal to help us get it. And the whole country was delighted. Don't speak. Don't speak. That was your cousin. Kian O'Connor is your cousin.
Mum's boyfriend's son?
Your mother's boyfriend's son. Well, what happened was that the whole country was having an amazing time after winning the gold medal. Have I successfully moved on from that interjection? I don't know what to fucking say. It's like, usually when someone heckles says something like, you win. I cannot defeat you. And I'm Obi-Wan Kenobi meeting fucking somebody else. Somebody from Tekken. I have no fucking clue. You're not from my world.
I'm coming from...
No, don't speak. These people think I'm good. You're showing me up for the staid, non-thinking few. You deserve your own show. You deserve your show. In the street talking to strangers, telling them stuff that you know. Don't even speak now because I come all the way from Milan and I really want to be funny. No, don't even speak now, dear. Just be quiet and know that you're the best ever. Just know you're the best. Please let me get on my shit show. No, don't speak. You punch her. You fucking punch her. Anyway, back to the show, as I fondly remember it. But it was a huge thing, and we had to give the medal back. We did, because the horse was on drugs. You know, and it was a disgrace. It was absolutely a disgrace. It was very embarrassing, and Kian O'Connor, Nadia's cousin, she fucking knows everybody in my show, doesn't she? Has anybody here ever met anybody famous? I met Prince Charles.
I met Margaret Thatcher.
You always have to fucking trump whatever I do, don't you? He's my cousin, my dad's Algerian, I met Margaret Thatcher.
I don't think she was fucking delighted about this. Yeah. Why, Nadia, why did you meet Margaret Thatcher?
The work that I was doing at the time.
Oh, really? What work are you at the
time? I'm working for a company in London called Council for the Advancement of Arab British Understanding. And we shook hands.
Taxi for two.
Well, Milan, that's the end of our little time together. It's been interesting. I've very much enjoyed the performance here. It's been different. And thank you very much for listening. And buonasera. No?
Yeah.
Buonasera. Arrivederci.